Hello everybody and welcome back to Thornton Farm. So it seems that overnight the crops have grown, totally. So this means that everything is now ready to harvest. This is a bit unexpected, I thought it would be a lot longer than that. But clearly having the growth speed on normal is a lot faster than I actually expected. So it means that we can actually begin the harvest if we wanted to. But there are a few things we need to do first of all. One of which is tidying up a tree. And that is in the agroforestry field. Now I do have an issue with this tree, and that is that it's planted in the wrong place. This will have happened when I was planting everything, and really it's in the way of the combine. So what we need to do is we need to, well, I suppose we need to cut it down and push it to the side. I was going to say sell it, but I don't think we'll be able to, because otherwise we're going to crush way too many crops. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut it down. And we need to get a bit of a log fork for this, so if we buy one of these, then it should work. They're not too expensive. Okay then, so about half an hour on, and we've had the log fork delivered to our farm, so we're going to put it on the front of our compact tractor. Now this tractor's top speed, of, as I've mentioned before, is about 9 miles per hour, I think, nine in forwards and 8 in reverse. Which is okay, but for a compact tractor that is still a bit too slow. So what I might do is try and speed this up in the XML file. I think it is possible. So if I can get it to about 15 or so, that would probably be quite good because, well, mine's 13. And I would have thought this one would be, yeah, about 13 to 15-ish. So yeah, if I can get it speeded up a bit, it would be pretty good. 9.4 is what we've maxed it out at, so that is just a bit too slow. But overall, a very good mod. Now, yeah, the diff lock does seem to be switched on for some reason. We'll switch that off. Right, so this is not going to be any kind of big logging video. This is literally, I think it's one tree actually. All we need to do is cut it down and push it to the side of the field. When the field is harvested, we'll pick it up when we cut the other trees down. I think those trees, are they on their final growth stage or the one left? When we get a bit closer, we'll know exactly how progressed they are. Yeah, it's a bit of a shame. This field, I was hoping to see it when it was all yellow. But for some reason, it's gone ripe very quickly. All I've done is literally skip one night time. So the reasons behind that, I'm not too sure. It could well be, I'm not going to blame anyone here because I hate blaming people, but what I've done, because I've been playing on Maxalium server, I've downloaded loads of mods, all the mods you need, it's like 100 or something. I suppose there is the potential for there to be something in there which makes the crops grow a bit quicker, but I'm not too sure. Obviously, I've got nothing to justify that claim, so forget it. It's probably nothing, and it doesn't even matter anyway. Anyway, this tree here is the tree which is at fault. Now the crops are grown, it doesn't really look too bad, but if you look in line here, you can see they're all roughly here, but this one sticks out way over here. So we do need to get rid of it. Otherwise it's going to be very hard to combine. So yeah, in real life you'd usually take a chunk out of the tree, like a triangle. But in Farming Simulator that just doesn't really work. It is possible, but it's not too easy. Right, so depending on where that's going to... If that rolls to the middle, we won't even need this. It's a crazy tree. It's spinning. We might just have to wait for it to calm down a bit. I mean, finding it in here is going to be quite difficult. In fact, I might even harvest this field, because this is going to be quite tricky. Yes, this is not exactly easy. You've got this spinning tree in the middle of an oat field. Yes, that has not worked. That has not worked at all. Anyway, yes, nutrients for some reason sometimes too, because we did spray it. I don't know why it's quite so low, but it's better than nothing. So that's okay. What we'll do is, I think we're going to get the combine. Oops, nope, go back there because I'm not going to teleport. What we're going to do is we're going to run back to the farm and we'll jump into the combine. Now this is going to be our challenge for this farm. When we've harvested everything, including the wood, we should be able to afford a new Lexion combine. Not new necessarily, but you know, nearly new, maybe a few years old. I don't know how expensive sunflowers are, so we better just check that. We will be doing that harvest very soon, but I'm hoping, really hoping, we'll be able to afford the Lexion by then, because it's a big field. But just here is the list of crops, and we have got soybean now, because we've got the mod. That is off the Manchester map, because they've got the mod installed for that. But I think it's, is it, no, the rye is at the bottom field. What we've got here is oats, but the sunflower is £594 per tonne, which is actually not too bad. What was that, the oats? Wow, look at the price of oats. That is amazing. Yes, we're starting harvesting today, no doubt about it. But yeah, because of the amount of mods you do need for the McStallion server, it means that we've got tons of stuff running. I have no idea what most of it is. Like, we've got the one up here which says the time and date. The real time and date. Oh no, it's just a, yeah, the real time. I don't know what that's called, that mod. I tried to find it in the mod list, but I couldn't even do that. So I couldn't remove it. I was going to remove it because I think it takes immersion out of the game. But yeah, it's not a bad mod really. There is tons of stuff running. Every button I press, there is a different thing happening. But at least we still have the notes mod. I've not got rid of anything. So yeah, this harvest has come on us very, very quickly. Much quicker than expected. It's no bad thing really, because we do need the money. But I was going to hold off for a few more weeks. But I think really the sooner we get Alexian the better now, because this harvester, although he's a very nice harvester, it isn't good enough for the farm. This farm is getting big. And we do need some bigger machinery. So off we go up to the oat field. We do have this one here as well. They might need a few more chemicals on them yet, but I'm not too sure. It's just come way too fast. But yeah, basically, when we have unearthed this log, which shouldn't be too hard, as long as we don't get it up in the header, we'll be able to push it to the side. So that's why I've still got the compact tractor there. That sunflower harvest is going to be so good though. That's the thing I'm looking forward to the most, but obviously this field is still very good as well because of the amount of money we're going to get from it. Hate driving through crops. No, hate it. The compact tractor looks really small when it's in a field, but when you're driving it, it actually feels quite big. I think I'm going to have to drop that header off there because there is nowhere else to turn around without crushing all the crops, which is something we really don't want to do. And I think after today's work we'll have to refuel the combine as well, because obviously it's getting quite low. 115 litres of diesel left. But let's get it hooked onto the front, try and stay as square as possible. And then we need to attach the PTO drive shafts. There we go. And yeah, that note really can be deleted because it didn't really go to plan. But love the mod anyway. So when we get the tractor and trailer, we'll just pull that header trailer out of the way. Actually, we could do it with the compact tractor. Yes, we will do. Jump out of here. See how handy a compact tractor is? Getting all these tighter areas, and it can do a lot of jobs which a big tractor can do. Obviously not the big heavy cultivation work, but just moving trailers, really handy. And we've got the front loader. And we've now bought a log grab, which we might not even need, but we've still got it. I think it will come in handy actually when we're doing the agroforestry harvesting. You know, we've got to cut these trees down, and I think then it will be very handy. But for the time being, it can just go there. I don't think we're going to need it again for a while. So back into the combine, and let's get some money in, finally. I think I'm going to span this over the last two episodes this week, because we've obviously got two left this week. If we can do probably half the field, then that would be ideal. Let's get the combine unfolded first of all. And I think I probably will bale this field. It's a very, very productive kind of field because we've got the trees in here as well. And I want to just really maximise the profits we get out of it. But here we go. Sometimes I don't do the headlands as a swath, and that is really just to save the mess, because it can be quite messy if you're turning a lot. But I think today I will do. I don't know if oat straw is worth any more than like wheat straw or barley straw. But anyway, we're doing it. This is going to be good. I've suddenly got excited because I know we're going to finally get some money back for the farm. And my dream is to progress this farm, like buy more fields and obviously upgrade the combine harvester. And without the money, we can't do this. So this is going to be really good. I think the log has pretty much ended up in the middle there. So we're just going to have to be very careful when we get to it. The three headlands we do first of all will be the priority, but as long as I don't sort of feed the tree up the header and break it all. But yes, it's actually turned out to be not a bad crop. Again, the nutrients isn't perfect, it's okay, but one of my concerns is weed prevention. I don't think anything looks worse than a field packed full of weeds. And yeah, in real life, if you had a field full of weeds, they would kill off the crops because they would sort of, they'd dwarf the crop and suffocate it, I think, basically. That's as far as I'm aware, anyway. So I don't know if that would affect our price, having no weeds at all. I'm hoping it would do. It should do, really. But that is my sort of limited farming knowledge coming through there, just breaking through. And really, these tram lines, they actually look really good. They're very faint. You can see that we've not really had much crop destruction there. So really, it's actually worked very, very well. This might be a good time to go back to the farm, get the Massey Ferguson tractor, and put the Marston trailer on. Because we're 65% full, which means we're not going to get round again. So I think I'll put the auger out now and prepare ourselves ready. Yes, we might only get two headlands done actually. I didn't leave a massive gap here. Okay, so I think, yeah, probably about here. We'll leave the engine running. Risky, I know, but we do need to, well, we can't just turn it straight off. It's been running hard, so let's go and get this Massey Ferguson. Certainly tires you out running all that way. Right, okay, so let's get it switched on. I think we need to drop the baler off. Yeah, there it is. Oh, it's already off, that's easy. And the trailer is situated just around the corner here. It's actually not a bad place to keep it. I quite like storing here. It's not really in the way either. Out of interest, I wonder what the productivity is on this sunflower field, because this is obviously the field we did yesterday. And I would have thought it would be pretty good. So let's just take a look. Yes, very, very good field that. That is times 6 nutrients. And time, well, that's nitrogen, and times 3 PK. So that is a priority. This field is a priority. We're going to have to get it done, whether we have the new combine or not. But it's going to be done next few days. We will reverse this out of here. And all of this is going to be sold straight off the field. We're going to basically be taking it straight to the sell point and maximising our profits. There's the combine. Yeah, it might just be a case of getting the headlands off today, I'm not too sure. I wouldn't mind getting that tree out though, as that is what I set out to do. It's amazing how time consuming harvesting is. Okay, let me just do that. Yes, I do want to just sort of maybe cuss up to that tree and pull it out of there. It does need to be done. But it makes a change doing a different crop. I don't really like doing, you know, just wheat every time, because wheat is, although not a bad crop, it's the base crop for Farming Simulator. And in fact, Farming Simulator 2008 only had wheat, amazingly. There was no other crop at all. There were mods available, but some people found it very hard to install those mods. It was quite difficult. There was a mod installer, which was a piece of software which assisted you in doing this, but not all the types of mods would work. So it was still quite hard. But I can remember how excited I got about that game. And I was trying for hours on end, trying to install a mod, and I just couldn't do it. And then, finally, I managed to get one to work after hours of banging my head on the desk. And I don't know, I was so excited. It's just a game. But I don't know, that game was, although if you look back at it now, it's terrible. It was somehow incredibly addictive, and you could tell there was a lot of potential in it. FS08 was just fantastic. FS09 was unbelievable. FS11, again, that was good because of the progression with multiplayer. The first game with multiplayer, which was heavily requested. I can remember in the forums in about 2009, everyone was wanting this multiplayer. And I think it even came about that somebody, a modder, was going to try and create a multiplayer mod. I don't think it ever came along, but I can't say for sure. But no, I don't think it ever did surface. So when FS11 came, when the announcement came that there was going to be multiplayer, I think everyone went berserk. Well, I can't say that for sure, but I was certainly very excited. Now, I don't think everyone went berserk, that'd be crazy. But yeah, a lot of excited people. Multiplayer is obviously a very good thing, and that they've stuck with multiplayer is also good, but it needs to be improved. So I'm really hoping that by 17, the release in October this year, FS17, I'm hoping it's going to be heavily improved, the multiplayer, because the aspects of that does need to be done now. Yes, although it works, synchronizing times are too slow. In fact, if it could be eliminated completely with dedicated servers, it would be good. And yes, I think the admin system is too weak. But if you're a player, it's fantastic. So this isn't some kind of rant video. This is just me, you know, pointing out stuff and basically congratulating Giants for having such a successful series. It is so good. Okay, I'll unload once again. I'm going to go back in the opposite direction this time, because we have got a bigger headland on the sides for some reason. That was just my terrible measurements. So we need to get them done. And then I'm just going to cut up to that one, that tree over there. We could leave it, I suppose, but I want to get it done. Otherwise, I'm going to forget. So I'm going to head back in reverse. If we can take this side up, then it's going to make everything a lot easier. It's actually, the measurement wise, it's actually turned out okay. I was kind of worrying we'd be missing too much stuff, but the width is perfect. This does vary though for each strip. I'm just very wary about hitting a tree, as that could be very damaging to the combine. It's quite a bumpy field. Oh, I think no, yes it did. Ouch. But that's that side done, so that's pretty good. Wait for that to come out the back. And now we're going to head up to the top and sort things out over there. Don't know how much there is up here. There's definitely something. Yeah. It seems to be growing in between the trees, so that isn't too good. But yes, when we come to bale this field, it's not going to be done with conventional bales because it is just a bit too slow. We're going to be using probably a square baler. It all depends how much money we've got. If we don't have much money, we'll just use the New Holland, but there is a possibility I'm going to sell that to replace it with a square one, as the prices aren't that different really. Okay, so that's that done. and then once more down here, and then we'll go and sell the trailer load. There's the tree. I think we're close enough to it there, otherwise we're going to hit it. And I think that will do. Wait for everything to come out the back. And then we'll put the auger out. And it probably won't totally fill this trailer, but that is a good start. The whole objective of this video is to move a tree, not to harvest a field. But now we've started, we're obviously going to have to finish. Yeah, that trailer is 54% full. I don't know if it has a cover. If it has a cover, then we won't take it to the sell point, but we're going to have to otherwise because it might rain. Lower that down, and then we'll put the ladder down. Yeah, does it have one? I don't think it does, so no. It's going to have to be sold then. But first of all, let's just go and salvage this tree, otherwise we're going to crash into it. It's in there somewhere, you can see it poking out the top. But this harvest would have been a lot harder if I hadn't cut down that down in the first place. I'm actually surprised the header didn't hit the stump. Okay, here goes. All I really want to do is just drag it out there and push it to the side. I'm not too worried about picking it up. It cuts across here. Okay, so it's definitely here somewhere. Yep, we've got the spinning motion. There it is. Spin! Yes, I wonder if the trees in FS17 look like that, where they spin. Probably easy from the cab view. Well, not cab view, but seat view. Driver's eye view. Okay, so yeah, it's just going to be a case of pushing it over there, but they do like to roll quite a bit, so it's quite difficult. There we go. Yes, you go over there. You grew in the wrong place because I put you in the wrong place. And I think really the compact tractor can stay here because we're going to need it again for the header trailer. So let's just put that down there. Switch the engine off. And jump into the Massey Ferguson. I do like this Massey Ferguson though. I like every tractor we've got because you do need some smaller tractors, you also need some bigger tractors. The issue with having like these massive high horsepower ones, although yes we do need them for the farm, they can only really do the really high horsepower work, otherwise they're just way too powerful and it would seem a bit ridiculous. For example, using a Fendt 1050 for picking some apples, which is something I did admittedly and I probably shouldn't have done. Yeah, another thing we need to do is the pigs, because we haven't done them yet and it would be a shame to finish the map without doing it. Obviously finishing this map is a long way away yet, but I need to make sure they are done, otherwise I think we'll be missing something there. Actually, I can't really see finishing this map for a long time. It could be one of those ones where we go up to episode 50 or something. Can see our destination over there, and I don't know how many tons we've got on board, probably about 12 or 13 tons, so I should think we should get, well, something over, I don't know, 18,000-ish, I don't know, can't remember the exact figure of what it's worth, but I don't know, 15 to 18,000 my guess is going to be. Let's see how good my guess is. It's probably going to be terrible. Well, it's going up quite quickly, I suppose. Wow, that is really good. £21,000. So my guess was, yes, terrible, but in a good way, because it means we've benefited from that even more. So if we get £21,000 from just half a truck, well, just over half a trailer load, then from that entire field, we're going to be very, very rich, and we have more than one field of that as well. So with that fantastic news at the end of here, we're going to finish for today, and we'll probably finish that field tomorrow. Yes, we will. We'll get it finished tomorrow and get all that done and dusted and see how our finances are from there. Because at the moment, we're obviously not doing too well, but there is a lot of potential on the horizon. So, yep, thank you for watching, and as usual, hope to see you again in the next video. Bye for now.